Hey guys, this is Tuhin here and welcome to my online class for watercolor. We are gonna be working on a dance posture illustration for which I have the sketch ready here. In this tutorial, I'm gonna be showing you how to use dark colors and then go over to the light colors and how to mix and blend them with water. So this time, firstly I'm gonna start off with doing the posture figure and then spreading water over it, and then I'll try fading out some of the details into basic washes. So I'm gonna start giving out a shade of Crimson Lake mixed with a little bit of Prussian blue, and I'm kind of directly painting the figure with darker colors first. So in between I'd keep adding washes of gamboge hue for a better mix. You can actually decide a basic hue for the whole of your painting and then start off with applying the colors. So I'm kind of just adding the basic details here, and it's not really necessary to keep inside the boundary, and you can keep mixing the colors between them to get better shades. So basically, whenever you're going a little bit too dark, you can try mixing it with water again, or you can dry your brush and rinse off some of the colors. As you can see here, I'm going from the darker colors towards the lighter colors. Now I'll add a hint of burnt sienna to get the skin color. So as you can see, I'm just keeping the boundary intact. I'm not too worried about colors not spreading inside. So basically the idea is to start off with the darker shades and then mix it quite accurately with the lighter ones. And as the paper is wet, you can keep adding all of the shades that you want to see when they are dry. I'm just leaving bits of highlights in between the shapes, and they're gonna come in quite handy when I'm adding the second layer of shadows. Now I'll take a flat brush and start wetting the sheet around the figure that I've painted here. And as you can see, the paper being wet, the different shades of color have already started to mix in. I'm just kind of giving strokes of different color and then mixing it with plain water for the transparent wash. Now for some cool effects to this, I am gonna take a flat brush which has harder bristles. And I'm gonna load some color on it and try to sprinkle them over on top of the paper. And while these little drops are wet, I'm gonna start adding a bit of details on the clothes here and there. I'm keeping these washes a little bit loaded more with water so that they can spread with the outer colors that I've provided. Try to get the necessary details on the first base wash itself, because the kind of wet paper and the mix of colors give you a really good finish. And I'm just gonna add the shadows simultaneously here on the lower part and a bit on the hands as well. Now I've finished up with the base wash and I'm gonna let it dry for a bit before adding the details. Okay, so now our base wash is dry and we are gonna start adding the final touches. So this time I won't be disturbing the mixes of colors that I've gotten all over the paper. I'm just gonna be adding a bit of shadows to give them a sense of boundary. Keeping the details very subtle here, I don't think I need to be doing a detailed painting. So I'm gonna give some dry brush strokes here for getting very minute details. So basically the idea is whenever you want a mix, you should load it up with more water, and if you want the details to be very fine, then you can go for a dry brush. Just giving a bit of boundary to the clothes. So that's where I'm gonna leave the painting now, and I'm gonna let it dry. So as you can see, I've gotten really nice mixes of the clothes and of the hands. So that's how the finished painting is gonna look, and yeah, these kind of droplets have given me a nice finish. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this tutorial, and like, share and subscribe to my channel, and stay tuned for more of my classes.